Tuning up here while people are checking in. Well, it's 10:30, and welcome to my living room here in St. Thomas. And welcome to Good Friday, I'd say. Hope everyone is doing well in their circumstance and blessing you in that regard. I know there's a lot of tender emotions floating around these days. I've had a few myself. And yeah, it's time to go in and just be at home with ourselves. It's $1,000 ticket if I go to the beach, so I'm not gonna go there. So, a little story. When I moved to Hawaii, in Kauai that is, with my wife and two children, it was a challenge to sort of fit into such a radical environment change and not so much land and weather, because I moved from Los Angeles with my family, but it was a frequency. Hawaii, it has an amazing energy that, you know, if you have the courage and the will to drop in deep enough, she may accept you. And if she doesn't, she will chew you up and spit you out. And Kauai is very famous for that. So I was looking for ways that I could really sort of fit into the culture and merge with the people. I didn't know any Hawaiians at that point. So I asked my Lomi teacher, Susan Floyd, if she could help me out with some of the Hawaiian language and some of the culture. And she said, yeah, I'll just invite me to dinner. I'll bring my boyfriend, and he's a kumuhula, and he plays guitar. And so he taught me that night after dinner. I recorded them because I couldn't learn them in one night. But he taught me six Hawaiian songs, classics, that really helped me a lot to fit in to the environment of Hawaii and the land and the people. There have been so many beautiful songs written about the land and the people. Dennis Kamakahi is one of the great writers of songs on Kauai. And this first one I want to play for you, just to kind of warm up the set here, is called O Koke. And Koke is the top of the mountain on Kauai. It's a state park. And the view from up there, down looking into Waimea Canyon on one side, and on the ocean side, you're looking into Kalalau Valley. Well, this song takes us through all these places. So if you want to open your heart and breathe with me, and just imagine that we're going on a little road trip to Kauai, that would be great. So blessings to Dennis Kamakahi and all of you for showing up on this auspicious day. This is my very first live musical video, so I'm really excited. Yeah. And I just love Hawaiian music. I'm going to be playing some originals as well, and I would like to play for you at least one song from my children's album that's coming this summer, called Three Kings and a Mermaid. It's a book. It's a book first. Or actually, the album and the book have been growing together for over 30 years. So be on the lookout for Three Kings and a Mermaid. Anyway, back to O Koke. So... let's go to Kauai. O Waimea, kupule aloha, never more to say goodbye, never more to say nani o ka aina o ka noe o ai ai o ka lala e ai lala i ka ua meili o ai mea kukule alo say goodbye. no A. Oh, I. Oh, kalala. Wow, that's a lot of fun. So, what are we doing? Well, we're on lockdown. Here on this planet, just spinning through space between where it's going, coming from, and where it's going to. And that's where we are. Lockdown. So, you know, today being the beginning of the Easter weekend, I thought to share a song for Yeshua ben Joseph in honor of him. Some say that his birthday is actually in April, the original birthday. So we'll celebrate this song called You Are a Star. And this song is written for you, because you are a star. And that's what this song is about. Letting your own radiance guide your life away from fear into love. All right. Now, I played this at the church before, and I know that you guys will remember it. So you're welcome to sing along. So here we go. A star for everyone, a true bringer of the dawn, helping all to find their way, trusting spirit more and more every day, and our souls shine so as we give ourselves away, teaching hope for humankind, one heart, one spirit, one mind, and our world is transformed to know God's love. Wisdom grows through our loving deeds, bringing peace into reality. You know there's no war happening right now? Garden of love in our hearts, sharing joy and beauty far and wide. We are free when we feel the love we are so very much alive, and our world to know God's love. reality. It's a conga solo. You are a star for everyone, a true bringer of the dawn, helping all to find their way, trusting spirit more and more every day. God's love without fear. That's really the trick, isn't it? To feel that radiance within us all that knows we are love in a body and we have influence over our emotional state, regardless of what it is. Yeah. Trust, it's a big issue. Trust that everything is okay even when it doesn't feel okay. Trust that we're doing and saying the right thing in each moment. Trust that when something isn't received by another the way it was given, that they'll not take it so personally. And trust that we won't either. We all make mistakes as our humanness unfolds. And yet the paradox is that we're all also perfect. So this next song is from the Trust album, actually. The Trust album is an album where I was in a very, very deep relationship after my first marriage. It had been going on for a couple of years. And when we established the relationship, it was a friendship for 7 months. And we dialogued about what kind of relationship that we would like to have. And we were embarking on turning a special relationship into a holy relationship, is what we were wanting to do. And boy, that brought up everything inside of me that wasn't holy. And that was very challenging. So when she called me, I was in LA working. I just left Kauai, where we were living, to go do a couple weeks work in Los Angeles. And for some reason, when I got on the plane as I was leaving Kauai, I just cracked open and I couldn't stop crying. I love this woman very much, and we had a great little place in Hyena, North Shore of Kauai, and relationship was going well. And but while I was gone, she decided to take advantage of our agreement to keep our hearts open and love unconditionally. So she met someone, and I heard about it on the phone while I was still in LA. And oh, it just went right through me. I there was no blame happening because we had set it up that way. So I had to just deal with myself and deal with all the emotions that were coming up around my beloved with someone else while I'm thousands of miles away. and knowing that our love was not diminished, that actually spiritually it was expanding. And so I wrote this song. This is how I processed it as I wrote this song, and it's called Free Falling. And if you listen to the lyrics carefully, you'll hear that there's a lot going on. So here we go. Free Falling. This is for Ida, wherever you are.
I love you as much as the dolphins love the sea. I love you as much as the rainbows love the sky. I love you as much as the birds love the trees. I love you just enough to set you free.
Now I'm free.
is a way of being that flows through our broken dream. Free falling, yeah. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, 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 oh. Honesty and love is a way of being that flows.
Oh, Angelica's on. Carrie's on. Hey, everybody. Awesome. Good to see you guys. I wish I could hear you. All right. Well, from there, we have to go to a love song to nature. Because that's what's really going on when we love another one anyway. Loving ourselves through the reflection of another happens all the time with nature. That's why all you have to do is go into the forest or into the valley, smell the grass, the flowers, the trees, feel the wind gently touching our skin. Sun, shade, doesn't matter. All the senses have become so alive in nature. And this is really where we're home, alone, all one. That word spells all one, alone in nature, where everything speaks to us if we have the capacity and ability to listen. And this song, it began with a lyric. It's a very interesting story about this song. It's called Where My Love Begins. And the lyric was written by a man named Rick Granite in the early 70s. He was a good friend of mine. He was a vaudeville entertainer and working the cruise ships with his partner, Jimmy Carrazzo. One day I came over to their house in the mid-70s, and it was early in the morning, and Rick was really stoned. And I said, hey, bro, what's going on? He goes, well, I wrote this lyric. He says, I can't relate to it. It's kind of a folk song, and I'm going to give it to you. Well, Rick passed away with AIDS about several years after that. So this song is dedicated to Rick, Rick Granite, and it's Where My Love Begins. God bless you, Rick, wherever you are. You're still with us. When I try to fly, I can never reach the sky. When I run to the sun, my race is lost before it's begun. But when I move
like the wind, that's when I know. I lean on my dreams. Life is never what it seems. When I feed on love's great need, sometimes it's gone with lightning speed. But when
oh, thank you guys for showing up. This feels really good. It's like my new gig. They closed all the restaurants and the lounges here that I was playing in. So here I am now with you on the West Coast. Fancy that. Yeah. Okay, let's see here. Let's play another Hawaiian song, because I know you guys love Hawaii. So this is a song written by Frank Kavaya Kapua Kalani Hewitt, otherwise known as Lehua. And it's called Kawai Lehua, Ala Kahonua. And the Lehua blossom is a beautiful bottle brush flower in Hawaii. Mostly seen red-orange. And I say bottle brush because you know how those of you that are parents, you had that bottle brush that would go down into the bottle and clean it out, and it was all kind of like, you know, and all these long hairs on it. Well, those are the lehua blossoms on the ohia tree in Hawaii. And when that blossom falls from the tree that's hanging over a river, it floats down the river into the sea. And one of the verses could mean exactly that. there are so many meanings to the Hawaiian songs. It's so beautiful. Another meaning of similar is that when a woman gets pregnant and the fluids carry, you know, to the sea for creation. It's the best I can do right now. Sorry, Lehua. But nevertheless, we'll let the song tell you about itself. It's in Hawaiian, so if you close your eyes, once again, you'll be teleported to that beautiful paradise that we love so much. Oh gosh, a whole different song wants to be played now. Wow, that's strange. Maybe not. Okay, we'll do the one in English first. You gotta listen to them, you know, it's just all there is to it. Wrong song written by Willie Dan, recorded by Brother Iz. In Las Vegas in the 90s. So breathe deeply, close your eyes, and let's all go to a white sandy beach on beautiful Kauai. I saw you in my dream. We were walking hand in hand on a white sandy beach of Hawaii. We were playing in the sun, having so much fun on a white sandy beach of Hawaii. The sound of the ocean soothes my restless soul. The sound of the ocean rocks me all night long. Those hot long summer days, lying there in the sun on a white sandy beach of Hawaii. The sound of the ocean soothes my restless soul. The sound of the ocean rocks me all. Saw your face again. We were there in the sun on a white sandy beach of Hawaii. On a white sandy Well, there's another song made very famous by Brother Iz. Seeing how it looks like people are dropping off the call, I'm going to catch the last couple of people here with Over the Rainbow. So God bless you, Brada Iz, wherever you are, because he went over the rainbow. This is for you, Brada. the dreams that you dream, dreams really do come true. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Someday I wish upon a star, wake up where clouds are far behind me, where trouble melts like lemon drops, high above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, and the dreams that you dare to, oh why can I see trees of green, and I see red roses too. I'll watch them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Well, I see skies of blue, and I see clouds of white, the brightness of day, and like the dark, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Well, the colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people passing by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? Really saying, I love you. I hear babies crying, and I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than we'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Upon a star, wake up where clouds are far behind me, where trouble melts like lemon drops, high above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, way up. The dreams that you dare to, oh why can I, Isn't this a cool instrument? I just love my new ukulele. Looks like a violin, eh? Yeah, huh? Yeah, got a great sound. Look how it's bowed. It's got a, you know, a bulge, just like a violin on top and on bottom. Yeah, it's very cool. The new Kala series. So let's see here. Let's tune this puppy up. And then let's go back to Kauai. There's an island across the sea, beautiful Kauai, beautiful. beautiful Kauai. And she's calling, calling to me. She is beautiful Kauai, beautiful Kauai. In the midst of Fern Grotto, Mother Nature made her home. In the falls of Wailua, lovers often roam. So I'll return to my isle across the sea, beautiful Kauai, beautiful Kauai, where my granddaughter is waiting for me. Beautiful Kauai, beautiful Kauai. In the midst of Fern Grotto, Mother Nature has made her home. In the falls of Wailua, lovers often roam. So I'll return to my isle across the sea, beautiful Kauai, beautiful Kauai, where my true love is waiting for me, beautiful Kauai, beautiful Kauai, beautiful Kauai. Oh, how I love that island. Oh my gosh. We went to Kauai for the first time. My wife and youngest was three. My oldest son was three. We were 5 months pregnant with our second son. And we didn't know anyone on the island at all. And it was her birthday was coming. It was May. And so, well, before we left Los Angeles, I said, where would you like to spend your birthday in Hawaii? And she goes, well, bring me a map. So I brought her one of these little camping books, you know, with had a sketch of each island telling about where all the campsites were. And she says, okay, which is the greenest island? Which is the greenest island? So I said, well, that'd be Kauai. It'd be the Garden Island. So I opened that little map of Kauai, which is actually the shape of a human heart, Kauai. And she puts her finger right near Hanalei Bay. She goes, that's where I want to spend my birthday. So we got tickets and we took a lot of camping gear because we wanted to camp and save some money. And I'll never forget, back then they didn't have the concourses that go from the airplane into the building. Back then in the 80s, you had to, the plane door opened and you walked down the ladder to, they call it the tar or whatever it is, and you walked across to the building to get, and then you went upstairs into the building. So as they opened the door and, you know, first contact, and as I approached the door to exit, I'll never forget, it's such an image, such an imprint, that this really gentle trade wind just brushed right through me as I'm standing in the doorway, and it said, welcome home. I was like, okay. And the family was behind me, and I went down and across into the building. But we fell deeply in love with Kauai, and I'm glad that we did. And so I think I'm going to play you a song from Hanalei, because I introduced that as where she wanted to stay. So Anini Beach is the nearest campground to Hanalei, and that's where we camped. And boy, it was raining and raining. It rained for 3 days solid after we set up camp. There wasn't a dry piece of clothing, a dry towel. There wasn't a dry anything. And we got rescued by this couple that was walking their dog. And they had a little son, too, the same age as ours. And they saw us all dripping wet, you know. It wasn't raining at the moment, but they said, "Are you guys okay?" And we said, "Well, not really." And they said, "Well, you know, we've got a vacation rental. Why don't you just come stay with us?" And they rescued us from the rain, and we got to use their dryer and dry things up. But nevertheless, we just had a full moon, and so I want to celebrate that moon from Hanalei. Hanalei is where a piece of my soul lives, and oh my goddess, God, do I love Hanalei. 2.25 miles of white sand beach. It's the largest crater in the state of Hawaii. Was. Kauai, if you don't know this, it's the oldest island in the Hawaiian chain, possibly in all of the Pacific. It's still the wettest spot on Earth, Mount Waialae, 450 to 480 inches of rain a year. Hanalei only gets about 120 inches, but it's so beautiful. So to walk that bay on a full moon night is something you really want to put on your bucket list.
Kauai, Hanalei.
Couldn't you just see it? Oh my goodness gracious me. Hanalei just lives right here, you know. All of Kauai does, but there's a couple of spots that have been deeply imprinted even before this lifetime for me on Kauai. Anahola is very familiar, Hanapepe is very familiar, but Hanalei, I remember when my kids were small, take them to Hanalei Beach, and oh gosh, it's the best beach for kids. You know, it's shallow, way, way out as you go. So I promised you a song from Three Kings and a Mermaid. So we're going to do that next. And I need my capo for this. Yeah, this album, it began about 35 years ago, and it's never been recorded. Oh well, actually a couple of the songs I attempted to record, but never got really serious about the recordings. But that's going to happen soon, because this album, so many adults who have children, and I've been singing these songs to their children for as long as the kids have been alive, they like these songs more than they like the other songs I've written. So this first song is called The Elfin King, which is for Jared, my oldest. And listen carefully, because there's going to be a test. Elfin King who lived in the woods. All the elves, they loved him so, they saw that he was good. One day he disappeared, where he went nobody knows. But laying by the riverside, they found all of his clothes. Rosebuds for his crown. His eyes, they sparkle oh so bright, they look like the stars at night. They look like the stars at night. Early morning the king undressed to take a swim. He did not know that the crystal pond him in to the world of boys and girls. Now we know the Elfin King is just a little boy. They love him so, he brings them so much joy. Late one night inside a dream, he found the crystal pond. Looking, he saw an elfin king adorned with magic wand. He wore a peacock feather gown, violet rosebuds for his crown. His eyes, they sparkle oh so bright, they look like the stars at night. They look like the stars at night. Waking and wondering about the crystal pond, rub rubbing his eyes and turning, he saw the magic wand from the dream that he had. I could see his eyes sparkling and just spinning in his head. Elfin King. Very good. Excellent. Well, I think that about does it for tonight. Thank you guys for dropping in. So good to see. Jeannie John's checked in. And Carrie Hunter. Angelica Jane. And Hope Corbin, my office angel. Thank you, Hope, for helping me set this up. And I'm going to do it again next Friday. It's an after-dinner show on the West Coast. And here on the East Coast, it's a bedtime show. And we will sing a lullaby next time. So blessings, and have a great Easter. Lockdown, inside. That's the access to the universe. And you know that as well as I do. Hui ho, malama pono, and namaste.